Hello, I'm Carloyn Brown, and this is the Life Sciences Institute. The Life Sciences Institute is home to over 700 researchers. There are almost 90 different research labs, and the researchers include both undergraduates, graduate students, and postdoctoral researchers who are working in those different labs. Researchers in the Life Sciences Institute belong to different research groups, and my lab is in the Molecular Epigenetics group. Why don't you come on up and we can check out the lab? Okay, welcome to the lab. So I've always really enjoyed trying to understand things that we don't already understand. And to me, one of the greatest mysteries is how can a single cell divide and give us the complex organism of a human or a cat? In my lab specifically, we study this process called X chromosome inactivation, where one X chromosome in females is silenced.
Okay, so this is Sam and Christine, and they're using the pyrosequencing machine. This will look at the sequence of DNA to find changes. Sam is pipetting the different samples, and Christine's just getting set up to load into the machine. We use the pyrosequencer because it can identify changes in the DNA sequence, and since we study X inactivation, we want to be able to distinguish between the two X chromosomes, which we can do by these changes in their DNA.
The question we're trying to address is how do genes get controlled? Particularly, how do they get turned off when we don't want them to be transcribed? And that is very important for understanding how tissues develop, how cells gain their normal role, and then what goes wrong in things like cancer. So all of the projects in our lab are directed to the same goal, understanding how one X chromosome gets inactivated. But generally everybody has their own specific project that they're studying that process with, and the students design their own experiments.
So now I'm going to take you over to our gel bench where we run DNA on agarose gels, and I think two of the undergraduates are there running gels. This is Kira and Surya, and they have been amplifying pieces of the exist gene, and they are now running those on these gels, which are made of agarose and buffer. The DNA is charged, so it will run through an electric current. Once they get their gels loaded, then they'll turn on these power packs and put the current through to separate the fragments so they can tell which pieces are present and can be used for future experiments.
So, research is challenging. It's hard to have the right question, and even when you think you have the right question and the right approach to answer it, things can still go wrong. And so it's very important to have a group who are working together. And in our lab, most people have different parts of the puzzle, and we think that together, hopefully, we can see the whole picture.
So here, Tom has been fixing cover slips. And in order to grow the cells on the cover slips, I think he's in the tissue culture room. So let's go over there and take a look.
So since we're studying a process that occurs in mammals, we need to study mammals. And much of how we do that is by culturing cells. Some of the people in the lab, particularly Tom, actually use microscopy to study what's going on with those cells. We're trying to answer questions that haven't been answered before, so you need to think about it in different ways, because people have thought about it the same way in the past, and haven't gotten answers, so we need to think about it new ways. And therefore, of course, new people, diverse backgrounds are really helpful. So thank you very much for visiting our lab. I hope you found it interesting to hear about the work that we're doing, and I hope that maybe one day we'll see you in the science lab.